Okay guys, today I'm going to show you my two new orchid. Three. It's a Oncidium and a two Oncidium and one Dendrobium orchid. This one is my Oncidium. This one is a very small one. This is a miniature and neither this also. This one is a very nice orchid. I love it because there is 11 of the mature or the big or the fully grown pseudo bulb or the fully grown Oncidium, but it still has 4 kinky that is growing. I'm going to show you this 1, 2 and here 3. That's at the back, the number 4. And basically I don't have any idea what kind of orchid is this, but its pseudo bulb is very flat. As you can see there, it's flat. But neither this. This, I'm guessing it's a share baby. That's a bit characteristic, I'm showing you. It has 2 leaves at the side and still have the big leaves here and here, and has this long one. So that's what I'm basing. And it has a new kinky. What I basically doing about this, it's about at least 2 weeks already that I got this. What I'm basically doing is, I start this 2 days ago. I put it outside in direct sunlight, as in direct sunlight, full hot sun, for about 2 hours after watering. Then I put it inside. I'm doing this every 10 to 12, so it's really hot that time, not early morning. And yeah, I just want to show you this. I'll show you again my Dendrobium, but if you have any tip on how to grow this, how to rebloom them, please comment below. Thanks. Or if you have comment. And the other one, I'll show you. Okay, this is my new one, my new Dendrobium. I got this, which is not in bloom. It still has a small spike. Well, this is the big of this, how big the spike is when I got it. Now it is my the farm said it has a white flower, which I can believe, but I think it's a pretty healthy bud. It's very green. By the way, this is a bromeliad or bromeliad, and also this one. Since it's summer, I keep all my orchids indoors, and all my orchids have kinky. I said all of them, except for this, I got new. Anyway, I just want to show you that, but let's go back to our Oncidium. Okay, here we go. And again, if you have any idea how to rebloom this, please comment below. So, just want to show you this, and thank you for watching. Oh, wait, just a second. I'll show you how small it is. This is a back bulb, or a back pseudo bulb, which is an old one. And it's as big as this, as the tip of my bone, in my pinky. Or my pink is even bigger, see? Well, this one, it's 2. So, but if you combine 2 of this, including the leaves, it's much bigger. This is only 1, 2, 3. This one is only 3, and 4, and 1 kinky. But it's totally larger than this. That's why I put it in a clay pot, and this one in a wood. Oh yeah, maybe it's in your mind that it has no aeration, but it has. Since this is a mounted orchid, I got this anyway from a friend of my mom. It's a mounted Oncidium in a palm tree, and I got a 3-pern slab. You can see it because it's black. Anyway, and I stick it in there, and I put some coconut hash at the side to keep some effects. I just want to divide this big one, but I can't because it will make the flowering much longer. I don't want to take that. I have seen some bloom up on Oncidium, and I think they're real lovely. I have seen Shea Baby and some other miniature, the white and red one, but I really love them because I have pretty much seen it all. And I also have a bandas. Anyway, I forgot to say that I have a bandas. It is a Banda Terrace. It is not your typical bandas. It is very thin, pencil like, but it has this huge bloom. I got it from a abandoned house which no one owns, and I get it because, you know, it's abandoned. Who will water the plant? Doreen? No, it's summer this time. I'm sure it will die. That's why I'll show you also my bandas terrace. It's a quite weird bandas. Anyway, I just searched it on Google and I find its name. Wait just a second. Okay, here's my banda terrace. And it's not your, I said it's not a typical bandas. Well, this is a mounted one. Well, it has a lot of slabs in them. I find 4 to 5 banda terrace in there. But as if you can see this, it's quite wrinkled, right? And also their leaves, it's they're like basically a twig. So no one really realized this is an orchid. And I have seen this had bloom in a house of the friend of my mom. I mean in a school. It's in a school. I find it in a school. The school of my cousin. And I've been there. And wow. Then I see it was a cutting from my old one. As you can see, it's cut. Dirty, it's cut. And you see there, it's really green. It's cut. It's just a cut. I guess I can do a cutting about this, but they usually reproduce into kinky anyway. This can grow over 2 meters long, or almost six foot, and it still has this green. So it means the roots are growing. Since it's summertime, it's really there when the plant become robust. Okay, so I take it. And I don't take all. I take only one out of maybe 5 or 10 of their colony, and I really love them. So yeah, this last of my collection. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, or anything. Bye bye. This is my banda terrace again. Bye bye.